Hello, I'm Kelly O'Byrne and welcome to LCG's preview for the week ahead. I'm here with Jasper Lawler, our head of research, and we'll be discussing the flare-up in Russian foreign relations, the Fed rate decision, the BOE meeting and the G20 meeting. But first, I'll run through some economic data and corporate results for the week ahead. We have earnings from Oracle on Monday, Bellway, John Wood Group and FedEx on Tuesday, Kingfisher and General Mills on Wednesday, Ted Baker, Accenture, Micron Technology and Nike all on Thursday, then finally Next and Smiths Group on Friday. Moving on to the economic calendar, we have the EU trade balance on Monday, UK CPI on Tuesday. On Wednesday, it's UK unemployment and wages and the Federal Reserve and RBNZ rate decisions. On Thursday, we have Eurozone flash PMIs, UK retail sales and the Bank of England rate decision. And on Friday, it's Canada CPI and retail sales. So Jasper, a chemical attack, it's a worrying thing, but is it worrying for investors?
It is worrying, Kelly, but I think from a market standpoint, it adds back in that element of geopolitical risk again, and I think it's probably been holding back equities in this last week. It's been a bit of a choppy, no progressy kind of week. We had thought that with the thawing of the relations with North Korea, that actually maybe we could put geopolitics on the sort of back table, but I suppose not. I think this has probably got further to go. There seems to be a general international desire to kind of ramp up the pressure on Russia. So the US have put on more sanctions on them. Obviously, there's the UK have expelled diplomats. Russia doing the tit-for-tat response with the UK diplomats. So I think it's probably going to get worse before it gets better. But Russia was pretty much already ostracized in terms of the international community. Mm-hmm. The only real effect that I could see this having is via oil markets and probably actually via the election, but it just seems like so, Putin has basically won the election, and so that means a continuation of the status quo in terms of Russia and what they're doing with OPEC for cutting production in the oil market, and so oil prices should be unaffected, and I can't really see any other avenue, really. How this is going to really spiral out of control and really weigh on markets.
Yeah, okay. And a trade war, that's still the hot button topic at the moment. What's the latest?
Well, I think the fears calmed down a little bit towards the end of the week. I think a lot of it was helped by the fact that first we had Gary Cohn pushed aside, or he stepped aside, whichever one it was. But he was replaced by Larry Kudlow as the new chief economic advisor to Donald Trump. Kudlow, he's pretty pro-free trade, and so hopefully he can have a positive influence on Donald Trump in terms of the tariffs that he's looking to implement. But still, it looks like these tariffs, specifically on China, are still in the works. So we don't have the details on those. So that will be the next kind of inflection point, I think, when we exactly know what the US looks to try and impose on China. But I think we know now that Trump considers these, the trade deficit for the US a big thing. Last year, under his first year in office, the trade deficit widened by over 10%. So he really wants to reverse this. And I think this is probably, it doesn't have to escalate to a trade war, but I think there are going to be more tariffs to come.
Okay, great. And so it's the Fed meeting next week. Am I right in thinking its rate hike is pretty much guaranteed?
Yeah, I would say you're right in that. It's been penciled in for a while, but I think with the non-farm payrolls coming in above 300,000, CPI well above 2%, even though the Fed's own preferred measure of inflation is still below target, I think putting it all together, weighing up the risks of how the market's performing, I think probably it's pretty much odds on that they're going to hike again at this meeting. So then obviously then the question becomes more about what they do going forward. I think there's a sense that actually, especially after Draghi seemed to kind of step off the need for tightening policy in the Eurozone, that actually maybe that's going to be a global theme and that Powell is going to do the same in the Fed. But actually I think based on his testimony to Congress, He was pretty hawkish there, caught a few people by surprise by being quite bullish on the US economy. And the data, for the most part, has improved since then. So I don't see any real reason why he'd want to backtrack. So I think he'll be hawkish again, and that will be a test for the market. Inflation's actually not really rapidly rising, yet the Fed still have this pre-planned path, perhaps a 4 rate hikes this year. So then the question is, can actually the markets handle it? We have seen a bit of a flattening of the yield curve again, so that's another sign of markets being kind of worried about where the Fed could be going relative to the economy.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then next, Bank of England. In your words, you're expecting a snooze fest.
Yeah, I think so, because we had the economic projections last time. So this time there's we do have the minutes, but there are no updated growth or inflation forecasts, no press conference. And there's been obviously a little bit of a kind of political flare up here with Russia in the UK. We're facing the deadline for the transition agreement with Brexit. So I don't really see why the Bank of England would want to kind of ruffle the feathers of the markets at this point and try and point towards the next rate hike. I don't see it happening, really. So I think probably the voting is going to stay the same and we're not going to see a rate hike. But still probably odds on for some time in the spring to get the next one.
Okay, great. And just quickly, anything to note about the G20 meeting?
Not a lot, I would say. It's always a lot of bluster without a lot of action typically at the G20, but probably Russia is going to be a topic now, and how to handle that. But I think probably the biggest kind of side note from it is that I know another big hot button issue is going to be how they treat the taxation of big multinationals, particularly the kind of digital firms, the big tech companies, basically. So Facebook and Google potentially in the firing line a little bit. So even though there won't be anything specific announced, I think they could sort of show the international intent. And if it means higher taxation for these firms, less tax evasion or avoidance or efficiency, then that means lower profits for them. So it's there's a bit of risk for tech investors, perhaps.
Okay, great. Thanks, Jasper. And thank you all for watching. If you wish to see these videos as they're released, please follow LCG on social media.